modding gives you the power to turn this into this. I am Kavou, and today I am doing a different type of video, and I will be covering modding when it comes to Fallout New Vegas, again the greatest RPG ever made. I will split this video into different parts. If you are only interested about modding your game or how a lot order should look like, jump to the end of the video or check the segments. I wanted to make this video a bit different than all of the other Fallout New Vegas modding videos I've made. My name is Kavou, I make Skyrim videos, but I also cover other type of games including modding. And welcome to my 7 tips for noobs and experts when it comes to modding Fallout New Vegas. If you want to mod Fallout New Vegas and you don't follow those steps, your game would probably end up crashed. I've decided to make this video because if you search me, I've made over 5 different videos where I'm going through modding the game, so I want to make something different. Let's begin with the first tip. That's right, this is Mod Manager. What you're looking here is the best tool we have when it comes to modding Fallout New Vegas, and it's my personal setup. If you want your game to run properly and if you want to mod your game properly, you have to use Mod Organizer. And I know many of you will say, oh Kavou, we know that. Not everybody knows that. There is people to this day who are modding Fallout New Vegas using Vortex. Go and download Mod Organizer 2.5. I will throw you a link. It's super simple and I will show you how to use Mod Organizer in the process. Let's go to the second tip. This is something I've started to do over the last year or two. Before that, I had all of my mods be completely packed in. What you see here is, as I've said before, my mod list. If I click those arrows, you see under the utilities that I've created, which is a separator, I have all of my utilities, aka all of the engine type of mods that need to be first there to run the game. If I go and click bug fixes, I have all of my bug fixes. If I click on the UI, I have all of the UI type of stuff, as you can see. This is extremely important because this makes modding so much more easier, guys. You have no idea. Before, I had everything mastered up together and it was extremely hard to create a mod list that makes sense. How does someone create separators in Mod Organizer? You see where my cursor is? You go somewhere on the gap, as you can see here, where you haven't selected anything, you right click and you select create separator. Once you click this, I'm gonna give it a completely random name, like subscribe to Kavou, and you're gonna get a separator which you can grab mods and put them inside here. For instance, if I want to put this on subscribe to Kavou, you can do it and you can move this anywhere you want. Creating separators or shortcuts when it comes to Mod Organizer, it is going to help you so much, and all the expert modders will tell you the same thing. So if you are new when it comes to modding Fallout New Vegas, I 100% recommend you to do that. I will post my mod list and my lot order in the end of the video, so you are free to check that out. The third tip is very similar to the fourth, and it is simplicity. You want your mod list to be as light as possible, and I will show you what I mean. Essentially, it's the idea of using as few mods as possible to cover as many things as possible. There is something called Viva New Vegas, which I'm going to cover as well later on. Simplicity is when you know what is missing from your game and you want to fix that. For instance, I don't like how the fast travel works in Fallout New Vegas, and I also think that the survival aspect of the game requires some overhauls, including some other parts of the game. Keep it simple means that you understand what your game is missing and you want to overhaul this. Maybe you want to fix the animations when it comes to guns. Maybe you want to install a bunch of combat mods or a bunch of mods that fix the survival aspect of the game. You have to make a simple list of what you want from your game versus grabbing and installing everything. You have to control the urge of installing any new mod that comes out, and the end result is less crashes and a much more better game. The fourth tip is very similar to what I've talked about, simplicity, and that's more with less. I want to show you something and I want you to tell me what you think. This is how my game looks, this is my vanilla setup and that's how my game runs, and you might say the game graphically looks so good. Well, let me show you really quick the goal. Do you see this? In my game, or what you are looking at, I am using the vanilla textures.
What the fuck is this piece of shit?
This is vanilla texture. The doors, most of the walls, and you might ask me, Kavou, why the hell do you use vanilla textures? I use vanilla textures because if you are going to install Fallout New Vegas Reloaded, which is a mix of shaders and an ENB, and then you put some basic graphical overhauls, you create this. You don't need 100 different graphical mods, and don't get me wrong, most of the things look vanilla, but I have graphical overhauls or mods that enhance, you know, random things. These are the NPCs, and look at the mirrors having reflection. This is because I'm using the real reflection mods, and because I'm using New Vegas Reloaded, it's why the game looks so crisp. Let me show you how everything looks during the night. Look at that. This is exactly like vanilla. It just feels much more better. That's my example when it comes to doing more with less. I don't know what this guy's doing. Another example of this is a mod called Transcendence. Transcendence is a mod, or should I say a basic game overhaul, it's like Requiem for Skyrim. Before this mod, I had to use Barter Overhaul, Raiders Overhaul, Mojave Wildlife Overhaul, you name it, I had to use over 15 or 20 plus different overhauls to fix the game. Then I had to use different ways to fast travel, then I had to use so many mods. However, Transcendence grabs all of those things and completely rebalances and changes the game. It is similar to collecting all of the Exodia pieces. Transcendence covers so many mods, and one day I am going to dedicate a full video just to cover how amazing this mod is. If you're an expert and you want to play Fallout New Vegas and have it feel like a completely new game, I have combined Transcendence in a Viva New Vegas setup, which works amazingly. But Transcendence essentially covers leveling and progression, adds new perks, adds new traits, fixes the economy, adds more weapons, fixes the companions and the AI, fixes the AI with combat. It does so many things. The little fast travel NPCs you've seen, it's one of the parts it has on the world. There is a recommended option, and there is many mods like the Living Desert or the Essential DLC merch. There are so many mods that by installing them, they are doing so much. And you want to get mods like that cover multiple categories of the game and they combine them in a single mod versus having 1,000 different mods for everything. Fifth tip is something very simple, and it is reading. In my opinion, reading is something extremely overpowered. When you scroll down through different modes, you can see what's compatible and what is not. If something is not compatible, it is going to crash your game. And when you read the mod pages of what you're installing, you understand more information of what or how should you install mods. For instance, an amazing mod similar to Transcendence that does so many things is Goodies. It's going to add a bunch of content that fits with the vanilla game, and it works with Viva New Vegas. If you scroll all the way down, you can read many things about compatibility, or even better, you can go to the post section and you can read a bunch of stuff of what works and what does. Reading is extremely important. Anytime you are going to install any mod, always read the description or spend few seconds or a minute or two in order to understand what type of mod you are installing. And here comes the sixth tip, trial and error. trial and error is the most important tip I can give you for both modding and making the perfect gyros. Essentially, every mod or two you are installing with Mod Organizer, always launch your game and test those out. Am I going to install Transcendence or Goodies? The moment I'm going to install those, I am going to launch Fallout New Vegas and I will spend half an hour traveling around the world to see if everything works or if the game crashes or not. You should do this on every single mod you install or every mod or two, because if you are not going to do this and you are going to install 100 mods or 200 mods in one go and you try to launch your game, there are high chances your game will break. So always do trial and error. And the last part of this video is the best tool we have when it comes to modding New Vegas, and that's Viva New Vegas. The website, I will have links for everything. You're gonna go and click the full guide over here, which gives you a very basic introduction to how to mod your game. When I talked about Mod Organizer and all of that, if you continue on this page and go to the setup, it will give you a list of all of the drivers you should have, which cause many problems. So by clicking that, it will drop you there. Viva New Vegas will tell you exactly what to install, and depending on what version you're running, it will give you tips such as installing your game. If you want to do a fresh install, we're going to move to the Mod Organizer section, where it will teach you how to use Mod Organizer. It tells you you can install Mod Organizer by clicking this. It tells you exactly the steps you want to do. It tells you how to create separators, which I've made a whole section on this video. It will tell you how to connect everything. And essentially, if you follow this and remember what I have said about reading, it's OP in Fallout New Vegas, so it has to POP in real life. If you go and read every single part, you're gonna have an amazing working game. And again, I 100% recommend you to check. It is the golden standard modding that we have on Fallout New Vegas. If you move next to the manual downloads, you have the Viva New Vegas script extender. And there is a reason why you do this manual. Again, Viva New Vegas explained this. Follow everything Viva New Vegas does. Fallout New Vegas mod limit fix. You click on that and it drops you exactly on the link, gives you the latest version you need. Viva New Vegas is the best way to mod your game, guys. Follow Viva New Vegas. Closing in this video, if you made it up to this far, you're super awesome. Drop a like, subscribe, I love you all. The last part is my lot order. Now, what I'm doing in my game, as you can see over here, I have a bunch of few mods. Viva New Vegas will have you install a little bit more than, what, 200 mods or less? I'm having almost double that. By finishing this video, I will have a full link of all of the mods I'm using, my lot order, and I will also have highlights on those mods, if you want your game to look like mine, or if you want to try and test some different mods. Even more important, if you want to have an example of what a full complete lot order should look like, so you can take an example and do your own. So again, I thought making this type of video would be way more useful than making the typical me going through mod by mod, installing Viva New Vegas and a bunch of other stuff. If you want me to have the other approach of me modding the game step by step, you can let me know down in the comments or by liking the video. I can do that as well. My name is Kavou, and again guys, when it comes to modding Fallout New Vegas, so an underrated last tip, try having fun while modding and playing Fallout New Vegas. Enjoy the process and learn from it. Try to keep a simple and a light mod list. The only reason why my mod list is that big is because I know every single mod that goes in and out on the Nexus, and I know with what works and what doesn't, because I've been modding Fallout New Vegas for over 10 years now. It will take you time to get to this level, but if you are new and you follow those steps and you have an example of a lot order, I think things will look much more brighter for you. Thank you again for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one. Until next time, stay safe and happy modding.